Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. You know what? On-site training is a spectacular way to get the members of your team all on the same page about C++ and the kind of work that you're doing at your organization. So reach out to me and we can discuss on-site training for your organization. Now, this episode is truly going to be a just for fun episode. This is not going to be a best practices or something that you should be doing all the time in your code, but just something that makes you think a little bit. Of course, before I continue, I need to encourage you to check out the video description so that you can see things like how to participate in the planning of C++ Weekly and how to check out any workshops or books or whatever that I might have available at this time. Okay, the idea is Lambda-only programming, and this came from a student. So I just gotta preface this. This really is just for fun. But let's do this. I'm going to create a flat map that is Lambda. I'm just going to make it a flat map of ints to ints. Now, what I've just done is a generalized capture here of a newly constructed vector of pairs of ints to ints. I've used decal type auto here, and I hope that the point of that will become clear in a moment. Okay, so if I find the key, then I'm going to return a reference to it. That's what the decal type auto gives me there. If I get to this line after the for loop, then I know that I don't have that value in my vector yet. Now, this fails to compile because it says that I'm passing a const vector to emplace back, which is true. We need to make this a mutable lambda. And now it's telling me that I've got inconsistent types because that is an int and a pair of int here. So I actually need to return a second there. And now these should both be int references. Now what we have created is this flat map, which behaves just like a C++ map, but is, well, flat. L value required is left operand of assignment. So we can see we actually didn't get the int reference that we wanted. Let's do this. Instead of decal type auto, I'm going to do auto ref and require that a reference be returned. That should get us working. There we go. Okay, so now we have a flat map and we can do things like, don't we all long for the days where standard print from C++ 23 is actually implemented by our compilers? Okay, very good. We're getting 42 printed from our program. Everything is working as expected. We have a flat map implemented entirely as a lambda. Well, I told you that things are going to get a little bit wonky here. Let's do this. Let's make a variadic set of inputs. Now, this is where things really are going to get weird because the compiler doesn't know. If I've passed in more than one, I've got this. It's an unexpanded parameter pack, although it's not really giving me that error. So I need to expand the parameter pack, which again is not going to do anything good because it makes no sense to expand this here, even though I am calling it with only one value. So to get this to actually compile, I'm going to have to do a C++ 17 fold over the comma operator. So the quote last item is the one that's actually used for the comparison here. All right, that works. Now, why did I go through this? It's so that I can do ridiculous things like this. Okay, I am doing an indexed operation here if I pass in one element. Because I have this if constexpr for the parameter pack size is one, then do this. Otherwise, I am returning a reference back to the underlying data itself, which means I can do things like this. Now, this is probably a spectacularly bad idea, but there's more to it as well. I could, in fact, well, I could definitely do some weird things here because it is possible to actually define types in the generalized capture from C++ 17. So I'm really not going to take this example any further down this road of ridiculousness, but I can define a lambda that defines a new type, and so this is a lambda in this case, or I can immediately invoke it. So now I have some new type declared entirely in the capture portion of my lambda, and I can instantiate it. And then down here inside of my lambda, I have now access to a whole new type and a new object with its own lifetime. I don't know. It was just meant to be a fun little exploration into ways that you can abuse lambdas. If you really wanted to, you could go down this entire road and just use lambdas for literally everything. They are that flexible. I'll be sure to add this to my increasingly growing list of Lambda episodes in that Lambda playlist. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Hope you had fun. Be sure to subscribe.